spell it, and what title you want.
Actress, humanitarian, dog catcher, whatever you want to be. Yeah.
Alright.
Slate with your name, spell it, and what title you want.
My name is Stephanie Thompson. S-T-E-P-H-A-N-I-E. Thompson, T-H-A-N-P-S-O-N. And I'm an actress.
Okay, so what do you know about global warming? Talking to the camera, not me.
Okay, sorry.
You're talking to those people.
Okay.
Unless you don't want them to see you, you can be looking in our space like you're flying with ET, which is an interesting approach we haven't tried yet. From the top, take it fresh. What do you know about global warming?
Global warming is a serious problem that has been propagated by human activity on the planet. It's a big problem, especially considering the fact that humanity seems to, at this point, have no real regard for its safety as far as taking care of our natural resources and making sure that this planet is a place that we can live for.
So, what can you do to empower people to start caring and recycling? You're telling your friends and family or people you want to get involved. What's your pitch?
For many, many years, I decided to close my eyes and not research or learn about global warming or sustainability of our planet. Whenever I did so, I would get really upset, I would start crying, and I felt completely powerless. I didn't know what to do to assist in any way. I recycled, I knew that that was probably helpful, but then I would get disheartened. I wouldn't know what else I could do. I did a little bit of research, and I found this app that is called Bicot. And this app helps you to find products that do not in any way use unreusable components. Bicot is an app that lets you find products that come from companies that do not support any kind of political. If I were going to tell my friends of a way that they could help make this planet sustainable for our continuing population growth, I would tell them to look for this app called MyCut. I think it would be a great way. Sorry, I'm going to start. For a long time, I didn't know what I could do to help with. Sorry.
That's all right. We can clip stuff from that other piece you did. So, what would you say if you found out that your forefathers, aunts, uncles, or people in decision-making capacities have known for 50 years they could have prevented this and went ahead because there was so much money to be made and hopefully would figure it out?
This was all based reverse global warming, but at least keep it from getting worse, take no steps to do so because their only interest is money and greed and power.
So when you're telling your friends to do the research and know what's good and what's bad, how do you also get them to understand that maybe it's time to switch the products we use? We don't need new teak wood. We don't need new rhinoceros horns. We don't need another lion's head on the wall. Maybe we need to find a way to start coexisting with all life forms. What do you say?
Do this.
Tell you she can. You know why I'm having you do that? What can you receive when you're like this? What can you receive?
Nothing.
What can you receive when you start to give and open up?
Oh, so much more.
Okay. So talk about giving and opening up and finding the similarities, not the differences.
Mm-hmm.
Is that part of the solution? What's the solution so people finally say, it's not about race, it's not about color, it's not about socioeconomics, it's not about education, it's about we need to save our ass. How do you get that message through? Because it's not about race, color, greed anymore. It's about getting our shit together and pulling together as one in the same direction and boycotting the people who want to keep ripping the planet up. Why buy the products? The strongest message to a company or a government is when you cut off their money supply. You stop buying their shit and you start buying other people's stuff. Oh, they might have to rethink. These are not easy questions, I understand. They're rather complex. Picture and post. Just keep going. Don't worry about hiccups. Pick them up clean, right where you were at. Keep picking, just like you're doing a session. Take it on. Come on, there you go. Dance a little. Come on, get your booty on. Go, girl. Now smile, show that charm. Show me that beautiful woman that I met standing on the street. Not this timid little shy person who's like, oh God, come on, bring it on. Show me you. Get naked here. Is that how you would tell your friends to get on the wagon with you?
Well, you know, I want you to convince people. This is your best acting job ever. If you're not acting, you're being real. And that's not the fun.
Because now you have to be raw. So strip it down. Get out of actor mode and get into passionate human being. I'm a humanitarian. I'm going to change the world one person at a time. Start with me now.
We as a society, as a people, as a human race, we have to understand that issues with politics, we have issues with all these different things that in the big picture do not matter. The thing that matters is that we start taking care of the planet that we live on. If we don't, we're not going to survive. And if we don't survive, none of those other issues are going to matter at all.
How did that feel?
Better.
It was so much better.
I don't know. What do you guys think?
I mean, you just came to life. You just blossomed like that tulip in the rainforest is now saving kids' lives, because if we had dropped on the thing, we wouldn't have found the cure to children's leukemia. And it's that violet in the rainforest that made the difference. 99% of what's in the rainforest, we don't have a freaking clue, because we're ripping it down that fast. You discover less than 1% get the fighting cures for leukemia, cancer, and all kinds of stuff in these forests.
How does that feel? What does that say to you? How do you say it back to someone else?
We have a problem with overconsumption, and that overconsumption has to do with we want specific products. We want specific products that we know. And the problem is the products that we know are generally products that come from the rape and pillage of the natural world of the rainforest. The rainforests are so important. We don't know half of the things that are in the rainforest, half of the species, half of the plant life. There's so much in the rainforest that we can learn from. There's so much about how the species in the rainforest coexist with each other, how the plant life coexists with each other. We just ignore it. But if we paid attention to it, maybe we could learn a few lessons on how to coexist with our habitat, our natural environment.
This year alone, we'll lose between 500 to 1,500 species conservatively, and next year it could quadruple because of global warming. Why is it so important we stop right now? Oh, by the way, we're also 1 degree away from global meltdown and bio-eco disasters. Forgot to mention that. 1 degree.
I'm a big fan of Star Trek. I love these utopian societies that have been built in the future. None of those could have happened without a point, the kind of point that we're in right now. This is a critical point in human history. If we are able at this moment to recognize the devastation that we are wreaking on this planet, if we're able to recognize and take steps to prevent the damage we've already done and to perhaps reverse it, we could maybe move forward into one of those utopian societies, one of those societies that we think right now could never exist, because all we see is the greed, all we see are the politicians who don't care, the people in power that don't care. But if we take steps to try and change their perspective, I personally believe that that kind of society, that kind of utopia is feasible and maybe reachable within the next 100 years. I don't know, maybe that's sort of a pipe dream, but I think it's possible.
We're in the next 10 minutes, depending on how fast we keep going with technology.
Your whole energy is getting so much better. Keep that flow.
You can even notch it up if you want. So, why should people be concerned? Because we now, we were the family generation, and we were the me generation, and the me generation, the I generation. Now it's just the self-centered generation. Get the fuck out of my way. I want a number 7. I want it now. Extra pickles. Don't talk to me.
Mm-hmm.
We become such a jaded society. How do you touch those people who go, well, that's just those Americans, and they don't want us to have the same stuff they've had for years. Fuck them.
How do you convince people who believe that this is just all propaganda to change spending habits and change global buying patterns, and that this is really no joke? This is real.
I mean, it's only been the hottest summer in history in the Middle East, 165 degrees this year. I don't know about you, I don't do well above 100. I'm not even doing well above 85 most days. 165 is double that.
Global warming is something we can no longer ignore. In the Middle East, it livable. And that's a temperature increase that is completely unsustainable. If we don't stop with this, give it to me now, I want what I want now, don't bother me attitude, it's never going to change. In fact, we may not be here for that much longer if it doesn't change. The things we can do, I grew up watching Fern Gully. That movie gave me such a different perspective on rainforests, how they're important. I know it's fantasy, I know they're fairies, they're awesome. We don't know what's in half of the rainforest, there could be fairies. But the important thing is that we stop with this, I want it now, I want it my way attitude. Changing is hard. I know, I've tried and it's really difficult. We have the products that we like, we have the food that we like to eat. But if we don't open our minds and accept that some of these things aren't good for us, but also aren't good for the planet, it could just be really bad. We have to change. For me, a paramount tactic that I have started to use is an app on my phone called Bicot. I can put in my phone that I don't want to support palm oil, that I don't want to support the use of GMOs, I don't want to support Monsanto food, because I believe that's bad for me. And with the help of this app, I can change my buying habits. It's difficult. I go to the store, I find something that I generally buy, and I find, oh my gosh, they give money to Monsanto, they support deforestation. And I then have to go find something, a different product that doesn't support those things. It's difficult. But if we make little changes like that, it can have a drastic impact on our planet in a positive way.
Pesticides versus organics. Well, we can see that was an insane idea.
Pesticides versus organics.
When you talk about pesticides versus organic food, oh my gosh, I get so frustrated. I am called granola because I support organic food. It's healthier for you. It's healthier for the environment. And I don't want to put poison in my body anymore. You know, the rate of cancer, the rate of Alzheimer's, the rate of Asperger's, all these have gone up astronomically since we started messing with food. It's a terrible idea. Organic is really the only way to go if we want to be a healthy society. Once you start chemically altering Mother Nature, it becomes a problem. We're seeing that in our own bodies. How can we ignore that? Once the levels of cancer, once people start suffering because of what they're eating, you can't ignore the signs, you can't ignore the facts anymore. People have to start eating organic, people have to start growing organic, and people have to stand up to companies like Monsanto who insist on polluting our planet and polluting our bodies.
Artificial ingredients, things I can't pronounce, over-medicated, bloated society. Wow, what a bleak future. It looks like the world is melting and we're becoming obese and neurotically insane from things we can't pronounce that we're putting in our body. Suggestion? Sodium, 600% in something. We've become so artificial that it's important to keep that artificial going. Or is it? It's time to get off all the medications and things we can't pronounce. Let's try to go natural and see if we're really that wiped out.
I'm 29. I grew up in a generation that didn't eat real food. My generation has become very dependent on fast food, has become very dependent on products containing ingredients that we can't pronounce. It has been suggested that, hey, we're not going to survive without these kinds of products because the natural ingredients, the foods that are natural, the products that are natural, that have ingredients in them that we can pronounce, it's been said that those cannot sustain us anymore. I absolutely do not believe that. if you're going to the supermarket, if you're going to the grocery store and buying things that you can't pronounce, those aren't nutrients. Those aren't anything that's going to aid your bodily functions. They're chemicals. They're things that are going to harm you. They're carcinogens. You can't eat them anymore if you want to grow up with a future free from cancer, which is with a future free from Alzheimer's. You just can't do it.
So toxicity is an important issue with rainforests because they supply about 40% of the planet's fresh air. And with a growing population of over 7 billion people, if you cut out 40% of people's lungs and they already have cancer, they already have asthma, they're already gasping for air, and the air quality is diminished by 40%, nearly half the air quality gone.
Trees make air.
And we're taking out these trees that are huge, they're hundreds of years old, that have been producing massive amounts of air.
And we're not even putting a little saplings back. And I don't know, is it 10 saplings to every 100-year-old tree, or 100 saplings to generate the same air today that we had before that tree went down?
The more our population grows, the more pollution it produces. The scheme, what is that called? What do you call
the big plan?
The model
society.
The more the population increases, the more pollution it is producing. The model by which we are living is not sustainable. We're not only polluting the atmosphere, but we're cutting down the only resource that we have to make oxygen. We're going into rainforests, we're cutting down these 100-year-old trees that produce oxygen that is, I mean, that's what we suppose. You're going into the rainforest, you're cutting down these 100-year-old trees that produce oxygen. What do we breathe? Without these trees, without this oxygen, and with the levels of pollution that we are putting into the atmosphere, it's completely unsustainable. We're killing ourselves. It's the death of a thousand cuts.
What haven't you covered that you would like the world to know is your message, your passion about this topic? If you could leave the world with an indelible thing.
Change is really hard. Change is extremely difficult. I know I've tried. I continue to try because I don't always succeed. But if we don't change our daily habits, our daily routines, if we don't decide to make drastic changes in the model in which we live, we're not going to have a planet to live on anymore. We're seeing epic storms, horrible disasters, we're seeing droughts, we're seeing lack of food, and unless we make drastic changes, these things aren't going to change. Our planet is not going to be able to recover from the amounts of pollution that we are emitting.
We didn't have you do prognosis, did we? Mm-hmm. Okay, so do you remember I was pushing people off to do it? Can you take over and direct this part?
Yeah.
Thanks. Your AD role.
Cool. So, you want to say your name? Because you said your name and spelled it out. I didn't even do that. So just like around 30 to 60 seconds. Talking about the film Narada's Rainforest Should Not Die. And you mentioned the website naradasrainforestshouldnotdie.com and why people should see the film, and kind of a general thing for how all these awful things that are going on, how they are affecting the planet, and how that affects people. can't do some sustainability or whatever. It would be like if you're talking to a friend or family member about what this project is and kind of impassioning them to the action too.
My name is Stephanie Thompson. I support Moradic Rainforest Should Not Die.com. I don't think I said that right.
Moradic Rainforest Should Not Die.com.
It's tricky. My name is Stephanie Thompson. I support Moradic Rainforest Should Not Die.com and Social Media. It's important to research the preservation of our rainforests for a better tomorrow.
Can you do one thing with it? Like, if it's something specific, whether it's like all of us working together by deciphering and being educated about what's going on, how big businesses.
Kind of list through the different things that we can do as individuals, like growing trees, growing gardens, eating organic food. We talked about the boycott app, but also being mentally aware of what you purchase, so shade grown coffee versus coffee grown.
How do we do?
One more.
All right, me and my friend, we met on the street somewhere in Hollywood.
We did.
And I said, hey girl, you want to come meet my fam? And she said,
yeah.
Are you for real? And stuff like that. And then she looked at my card and then she called and stuff like that. And now she is. She's from Indiana.
I am.
Do they still want you?
Huh?
What part of Indiana?
Michael Jackson came from him.
Gary. Michael Jackson's from Gary.
Gary.
Oh, yeah.
Michael Jackson family.
James Dean.
They're from Gary.
Sorry, Gary, I've driven through that city. It stinks to high heaven. Pittsburgh was worse, but you beat them.
Paper plants.
Yeah, paper plants. You have paper ants?
What?
You have paper ants?
Plants.
Oh, I just said ants. I was like, are they mache or whatever? Yeah, yeah.
So why did you come to the rainforest bowl? Tell me why I should feel it from you. Bring it on, girl. Hallelujah. It's the gospel according to Indiana Girl.
My name is Stephanie Thompson, and I support MoradicRainforest.com and so do you. It's a website that will educate people on how we can preserve our rainforest and the importance of why we should do so. If we choose to buy products that do not contain palm oil, if we choose to buy furniture that does not use wood from rainforests, we can prevent the cutting down of these 100-year-old trees that produce oxygen for us, but that also are the habitat for multitudes of animals that we haven't even discovered yet. It's very important that we protect our rainforests, and Moradic Rainforest Should Not Die.com is a great resource to use so that you can educate yourself about what you can do in your daily life to prevent deforestation.
I think that was one of your best pieces yet. I don't know, maybe a little bit earlier, but I actually think it was one of her best pieces.
Could you also list through some of those things I was talking about?
Did you?
Just one thing you're going to say.
That's fine. But your energy level is really getting better. I'm going to step out so you can have better energy.
Okay.
Or I'll come back and terrorize you again.
Ouch, that hurt.
There's many things you think of off the top of your head that could contribute.
If we can make changes in our lives, small changes like recycling, buying shade-grown coffee as opposed to coffee that promotes deforestation, buying shade-grown trees like yerba mate that come from sustainable systems of planting and harvesting. If we can plant trees, if we can pay attention to our daily routines and make small changes in them, we can save the rainforest.
What would you say if you were in a room with the head of Exxon Mobil and you just found out if you had the ability to make the change in the world and you could tell them whatever it is you wanted to do, this is what you have to do now. You owe a debt to society. Exxon just was revealed in the last 30 years or so. They've been hiding and manipulating the story. Exxon is the one to blame in a little way, in a lot of ways, because they have convinced everybody on just the right side or the money side that global warming is not a problem. If they've been honest, they're getting, there's real documentation. It's basically like they've been lying to everyone, they've been deceiving everyone, and on top of that, bribing and paying off people to spread their own agenda. If you were in the room right now and this was the head of Exxon, what would you have to say to them?
I'm talking to you right now. You know who you are. You've been manipulating the media. You've been spending money on brainwashing people when you could have been putting that money towards saving the environment. I know you probably don't care about the environment. It's evident from your spending habits. But you have to change. You are a vital part of the problem. And if you don't give back some of what you have taken, not only from humanity, but from planet Earth, you are going to be the one that causes humanity to become extinct. And that is not an exaggeration.
Good. Now, let me hear it in a more thoughtful way as far as what you should actually do.
Okay.
Just a couple of things. You don't have to whisper everything. Just what comes to mind.
The problem is I don't know what a lot of
their practices are. You don't have to get so specific, just think of it in a general way. Like,
mm-hmm.
like what are the things, because we can do things on a small scale.
Mm-hmm.
What about corporate America?
Okay.
So this is addressed to corporate America, to the people who have the ways and means of the money and the politicians. You really know the story, but they've been hiding it from the people.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe because they're afraid of the population rising up. Maybe it's because they think we're all going to quit using their products. The fear factor of controlling the mentality of us, this is your chance to say something to them and the world to hear it. So whatever it is, it doesn't have to be exactly what I'm saying. I'm just speaking in general terms. If you're in this room and you can be angry, you can say, fuck you. You could say, what is it inside of you? I'm from Indiana.
Yeah.
We're real people. We don't lie. We don't deceive. Well, for the most part. We work the land, there are a lot of farmers. We have an interstate coming through my backyard into a rare forest of land. We have one of the largest forests in Indiana. But we have been told our climate's going to turn into a rainforest in the next 20 years due to global warming. Our state was not like this. But basically, it will, in the future,